welcome to the Saptak Archives podcast. This is a new initiative by Saptak, and our objective is to propagate our musical heritage and to build a vibrant community around it. We do hope you will enjoy the curated music we bring to you.
Namaste. I am Manohar Patwardhan from Bangalore. I am happy to be presenting to you a podcast on the female vocalists in the Agra Gharana. The name Agra immediately brings to the mind the exquisite Taj Mahal. However, Agra is equally famous for an illustrious gharana of Hindustani classical music. The gharana is known for its full-throated gayaki, robust gamaks, nomtom alaps, powerful and superfast tans that the male performers can easily achieve by rigorous taalim. Yet, some female vocalists in the gharana have carved a niche for themselves. They have imbibed all these characteristics of the gharana to suit their voice and persona, keeping the emotional appeal intact in their renditions. During the days when public performances by women in the field of music was considered a taboo, there were some women vocalists who gathered courage only to keep the lamp of music burning and present the purity of this art. Much later, in the 20th century, were the women recognized at par with male vocalists and were addressed with respect as Pandita or Vidushis, unlike Bai in the earlier days. This episode is a humble attempt to portray a chronographical order of a few women musicians of the gharana. Due to time constraint, I have chosen only a few out of the galaxy of musicians in the Agra gharana. In the beginning of the 20th century, the gramophone came to India and the women played a pioneering role in recording classical music of all genres like khayal, dadra, thumri and ghazal. Stalwarts like Gauhar Jan, Zohra Bai and Tarabai Shirodkar and many other women musicians of yester years rendered the music with great dexterity and mastery. There is a famous anecdote about Tarabai's concerts being organized to raise money for the war fund during World War I. Given the constraints of recording in those days, the length of the recording could be for a maximum duration of 3 minutes. These artists displayed the magnificence of this stylistic singing to cover the entire spectrum of the gayaki. Please listen to one such recording of Zohra Bai, a tall name in the Agra gharana, singing Rag Puriya. She was the shagird of Sher Khan and Kalan Khan. This is the oldest available sample of the gayaki recorded in 1908, more than 100 years ago. When you listen, please notice the full-throated voice, the means, the upaj, the sapat tans, so typical of the gharana. Also in the tans, observe the repetition of the notes 2 to 3 times to closely maintain the contour of the rag, which is also an attribute of the gharana. Thank you. I would also like to mention the names of three women vocalists of the Gharana whose recordings are not available but had made a mark for themselves in the field of classical music. Babli Bai, a disciple of Natan Khan and a contemporary of Bhaskar Bua Bakhle, who was held in great esteem by Bhaskar Bua himself for her prowess in singing. Vatsala Kumthekar, considered a prodigy and disciple of Ustad Khadim Hussain Khan Saab, she was at the peak of her singing career in the 1940s and was in Baroda alongside Ustad Fayaz Khan Saab, though much younger to the Ustad. Krishna Udyavar, a disciple of Ustad Khadim Hussain Khan, who performed in the national program in the 1940s but had to give up singing altogether for personal reasons. A very important milestone to encourage and promote women artists to sing in public happened in 1952 when the then Union Minister of Information and Broadcasting, Sri B.V. Keskar, overturned a 1946 order that debarred women singers who were tawaifs or courtesans from singing for the All India Radio. This can be considered as an important and a path-breaking revolution in the timeline of women musicians in India, which brought about socialization of music. The Agra Gayaki, which is primarily a Khayal Gayaki, draws its genesis from the Dhrupad tradition. The expansive alaps are presented in the form of Nom Tom, a typical aspect seen in the Dhrupad renditions. It is the only gharana that sings Khayal, Dhrupad and Nom Toms, although it was Fayaz Khan Saab who modified the Nom Tom alap in the Rupak style, that is, phrase by phrase or the ragang development, unlike the Merkhan, which is note by note, that is followed by Dhrupad musicians. Please listen to this beautiful rendering of a dhamar in the prayerful rag Bahaduri Todi by Srimati Sumati Mutatkar, an outstanding vocalist and musicologist of the Gharana, who was a shagird of Pandit S.N. Ratanjankar and Ustad Vilayat Hussain Khan. She was the chief producer of music at the All India Radio Delhi, and to her goes the distinction of being the first lady musician to perform the Dhrupad Dhamar styles of music on All India Radio.
Yeah.
bol banav is one of the beautiful characteristics of the Agra gharana. These are embellishments used in context of the bandish and the lai that brings out the lyrical emotion of the bandish. Please listen to a recording in Raag Purvi by Srimati Dipali Nag, where you can notice the delicate interplay of lay, bol and swaras. Dipali Nag was a revered vocalist from the gharana who was a disciple of Ustads Bashir Khan, Fayaz Khan and Tasadduq Hussain Khan. The celebrated Bengali poet Qazi Nazrul Islam ji translated two of Fayaz Khan Saab's bandishes and Dipali ji recorded it in her sonorous voice. These recordings were a sensation back in those days. I would like to thank famous musicologist Alaknanda Patel ji for sharing this information with me. Many musicians like Anjani Bai Lolekar, who had their musical foundation in other gharanas, blended their music with Agra Gayaki in a beautiful manner. Her training in the Agra tradition was under Ustads Anwar Hussain Khan and Vilayat Hussain Khan. Here is a recording being played in the Raag Shankara. You'll notice the illustrious workmanship of the artist in this melody, where the entire essence of the raag is captured in the very first minute in the 3-minute recording. Also, note the clarity and finesse of the Tihai Taans at the end. Her clear and highly cultivated voice appeals the listeners. Encouragement from family and to be blessed with a helpful support system plays a major role in the life of any female musician. We also have to admire the fact that many ustads and the pandits in the gharana would come home to teach their disciples, making Vidyadan their mission in life. This paved way for many families to encourage their daughters to take up music, as it saved the burden and the risk of stepping out of the house to learn music at a time when women were not allowed to go out or had many restrictions to do so. Ustad Vilayat Hussain Khan Saab groomed many women disciples, and some of them were Saraswati Bai Fatar Fekar, Srimati Bai Narvekar, Sumati Mutatkar. Ustad Khadim Hussain Khan Saab taught many disciples in Bombay. Some of his notable women disciples are Saguna Kalyanpur and Lalit J. Rao. Ustad Anwar Hussain Khan Saab groomed many women disciples. Among his numerous disciples, Anjani Bai Lolekar is the most prominent. Ustad Bashir Khan Saab taught famous vocalists like Deepali Nag and Aparna Chakravarti. Pandit Ramrao Nayak was a pioneer in propagating the Agra Gayaki in the south. Some of his notable women disciples are Lalita Ubhaykar, Meera Saur, and Lalit J. Rao. Ustad Sharafat Hussain Khan Saab groomed many women disciples, and the notable among them is Purnima Sen. Purnima Sen, a renowned performer from Kolkata, had Taleem under Ustads Vilayat Hussain Khan, Atta Hussain, and Sharafat Hussain Khan. She graduated from the Hunter College in New York, but was so fascinated to learn music that she moved back to India and pursued the Taleem in Agra Gharana. The Bol Banao aspect of the Gharana is very beautifully and judiciously absorbed from the Thumri genre. We can get a very beautiful idea of how this is done by listening to a Bandish Thumri sung by Purnima Ji in the Raag Khamaj. We will now proceed to listen to another great exponent of the Gharana, Vidushi Lalit J. Rao. Lalit Ji is considered as one of the harbinger and a foremost performing artist of the Gharana. She received Taleem from Pandit Ram Rao Nayak and Pandit Dinkar Kaikini. It was her training under Padma Bhushan Ustad Khadem Hussain Khan Saab for 14 years which made her a full-fledged performer in the traditional Agra Gaiki. Lalit Ji completed her bachelor's and master's in electrical communication engineering. She served as a chief coordinator for the Ford Foundation archival project at the ITC Sangeet Research Academy from 1989 to 1991. She also recorded for the Ethnomusicology Department of the University of Washington in Seattle for them to archive the music of the Agra Gharana. While many critics consider this gaiki to be male-dominated, given the usage of powerful expressions by way of heavy application of voice, the pukars, the robust gamaks, Lalit Ji has struck the right balance of usage of these expressions to suit a woman's voice without compromising on the gaiki. Please listen to her short Nom Tom Alap in the Raag Shri. You can notice the Nom Tom Alap unfolding the Raag so beautifully. There is a liberty to use murkis and khatkas, which enhance the aesthetics by making the rendition more colourful. You may notice the Vazandar, Zawaridar voice as in the expansion of the nom tome, subtle applications of the means and the reverse means that beautify to suit the mood of the rag. The pukar inching towards the tar saptak rishab of Shri establishes the essence of the rag, thus offering further passages of development in the higher octave towards pancham.
Rana. Bye.